Okay, let's go through just a few notes here. Just do a couple examples of each crown today, and then I'm going to turn you loose because I think it's pretty easy, and you can use a calculator and all that good stuff to help you out. All right, so we're in section 3.3 to 3.4. Now, next delays, we're going to be doing a little bit more hands-on activity stuff, which I think you like. So, it'll be kind of fun. So, but today is kind of the one day where we have to do some book stuff. We have to kind of get it figured out. All right, so we've been talking about mixed numbers, right? So we're gonna go through that today. We'll do a couple problems where I give you a mixed number, and you're going to have to convert it to a different form. Okay, we're gonna have to convert it. And what we're gonna convert to, we're gonna convert to improper. So I'll show you that. That was the one that you guys did yesterday. You guys like knew it instantly yesterday. We'll talk about that and do an example of it, okay? So that's what we're gonna look at. Now, the second type of problem that we're gonna have is, I'm gonna give you an improper fraction, and we're going to convert that. So we're going to convert that to a mixed number, and that's the part that's going to be kind of new, to a mixed number. And I'm going to show you the method I showed you yesterday. It seemed like you guys kind of knew what you were looking at there, but I want to make sure that you guys can see two examples. So I'm going to show you the subtraction route, and then I'm going to show you the one with long division. So you can kind of see division. So, yeah. So, but you'll have the multiplication chart in front of you, so you can always use that. So, and we'll kind of talk about that. Okay? All right. Questions?
No.
All right. Perfect. All right. So let's do a mixed number. So, Sam, fire away at any mixed number you like, please.
Did it a few days ago. 34.
And what goes after it? 20 over?
10?
Pick a bigger number. Bigger number than 20.
15.
15. Okay. Okay, we'll go with that. Okay? Alright. So now, our goal here is to convert this type of problem. We're going to convert it.
Is this the same as we used yesterday?
Yeah. So I'm giving you a mixed number, that's the one that Sam just created. We want to convert this thing to improper. So what that means, what does it mean to be an improper fraction? What does that mean? Is this a mixed number, the one you created?
It means some of the numbers are improper, I don't know.
Okay, what does it mean to be improper? What about the fraction?
I can't remember. Is it the top number?
Is?
Which is 20?
Top number would have to be what? What makes it improper?
Would have to be divided by something.
It has to be divided by something. But what about the top number compared to the bottom? What makes an improper fraction? What about top versus bottom? What's unique?
Numerator
and
denominator.
Okay, so that was good. So we got numerator, denominator. So now Eric, what can you tell me about a numerator on an improper? So he has a vocabulary to talk about numerator and denominator, but what's true about a numerator and a denominator?
Numerator is smaller than denominator.
Usually. That's usually the case, right? Numerator is smaller. But what's important about improper? It's not smaller anymore, it's
bigger.
So this is going to be the bigger or larger number, however you want to say it. It's the bigger number, this is the smaller number. Okay, does that make sense what we're going to turn these into? Okay, now here's the thing. You guys knew the little trick yesterday, how to convert this fraction, this mixed number, I should say, a big number into the fraction, into one of these. What number goes on the bottom for sure?
50.
The reason why? That number has to be the denominator.
Yep. So top one's numerator.
Exactly. All right, so that was the denominator. So this is the number we have to put on the bottom. So we got the denominator. Now, how do we get the top number down here? What was the rule that you guys told me yesterday? We called it a circle method, but...
Whoa.
It was called a circle. Because what do?
Multiplying the math.
Exactly. We take 34 times 50 and you add 20. This is going to be huge. It's going to be massive.
1,720.
Say it again.
1,720.
1,720.
Yep.
1,720 over
50. Yep.
That's my answer. That's what I want. Does that make sense? Bacon can convert. Okay, now. That's the first couple problems. You're going to have 10 of those. I think you can handle that. Okay, let's do another one. So, Eric, I'm going to have you pick another one. So, we're going to do two of these. So, Eric, pick any mixed number you like. Make up one, because Sam made a good one here. I want you to make up another mixed number.
21.
21 and?
31.
31 over? 41. 41, okay. Lots of ones. All right, that's fine. You have a mixed number, right? We have a big number, we have a fraction. That is a mixed number. So again, I want to convert this thing. So I'm going to take this mixed number, and I want to convert it to improper. That was good. I like a lot of ones. All right. So improper. So we're going to convert it. So what's the little rule? What number goes on the bottom?
41.
41. You know that's going to be the bottom, right? The denominator has to stay the same. That's how it's going to work. But how do we get the top number? How do we get the top? Just walk me through. Like, you don't even tell me the number yet. But how do we do it?
Times.
So what do we multiply?
21 times 41.
Good. 21 times 41. And then what do we add?
Plus 31.
Now, what was the big number you got?
892.
Yeah, I was going to say it was going to be 892 over
41.
That's the answer I'm looking for. That is an improper. What makes that improper?
Big number on top.
Big number's on top. That's not normal. You even said it. Like, usually, the big number's on the bottom. That's usually a normal fraction. Now, the mixed number. So we see it as improper. Big number's on top, small. But what makes this a mixed number? Why do they call it mixed?
I don't know. Sam, you got this one.
Why is this a mixed number?
Because there's three numbers instead of just two.
Three numbers? You're mixing things together, right? Yeah, you're mixing three numbers. We have a fraction and a whole number, right? So that's the idea. Very nicely done. All right. Do you guys think you can handle a couple of those?
Ten.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to leave those on the board. Now, let's do the other type. I'm going to leave those there, okay? Now we're going to do the other type. And this is where I'm going to turn my camera here.
Is your camera already on?
Yeah.
Right there.
Anyway, you can slide back if you want. No worries. Can't count with this anyway. Alright, so now. Improper. Now, we're going to take an improper fraction, and we're going to convert it now. So Sam, try to keep the numbers relatively small. I need an improper fraction now. Make up any one you want, but keep the numbers relatively small.
Okay. Say...
21.
This is not. You'll make yours up here.
About 10.
10 over?
10 over.
That'd be improper, so think about that.
So that's the smaller number?
Mm-hmm. Now smaller number. So what do I need?
10 over 3.
Okay, I like it. Alright, that's improper, right? We're going to take this improper fraction and we're going to convert it to a mixed number. We're going to convert this to mixed. So that means we're trying to make a big number out front and a fraction behind it. Now, here's the good news. What's going to be on the bottom of the fraction for sure?
Three.
You guys know that. The numbers never change there. Now, the big number up front and the small number on the top, that is going to change. Now, I know you guys like the little subtraction rule. I know that you guys really like that. So what we can do is you can try to tell me how many times can you successfully subtract 3 from 10. So if you subtract 7, so subtract 3 again.
7, 4.
4. Subtract 3 again.
2.
1. Okay, all right. How many times did we successfully subtract 3? Subtract it successfully 3 times, right? There was 1, 2, and 3. So successfully did that. What was the number left over?
One.
Boom, that goes there. Done. You count how many times did you successfully subtract, and that's the big number up front. That's one way. So you can just, on your calculator, just subtract three, enter. Yeah, so good. Subtract three, enter. Yeah, good. You just have to keep track of how many times you're doing that. Maybe we'll make a little tally marks off to the side. Not bad.
No.
Okay. All right. Eric, give me any mixed number you like. But, oh, improper, I mean, not mixed. Improper, please.
Hmm.
You can go with the one you were saying earlier.
Let's go 11.
11, okay. And over?
2.
2.
Okay.
So we'll say, why not put 21 on the
bottom? All right. So we have 11 over 2. So again, our goal is to take this improper fraction and we are going to convert it to mixed numbers. Convert to a mixed number. So now, we know that it's going to be a big number out front. We know the bottom number. What's the bottom number going to be?
2.
Okay, so we know that. So we already have the setup. Now, whether we're going to need the fraction or not will be debatable. We'll see that here in a minute. Now, we can do it by subtraction or you can do it by long division. So,
long division.
Let's do long division. Just to get a practice. I'll leave these both on the board. So, if we're going to do it by long division, the 11 goes in the house, the 2 goes on the outside. Mm-hmm. And that's how it works because that's my numbers, right? How many times can 2 go successfully into 11? More than that. More than that. 2 times 2, 2 times 3, keep going.
Yes, yeah, sorry to bother you.
No, you're fine.
On those coolers, do they take more than one big one?
No, we only take one usually. Unless you have a lot of stuff, then we'll take 2.
Because the boxes that the meals came in, there's no way to
yeah,
fit.
Just grab 2. We haven't stacked in that in the open closet. So
you can only go to 10.
Can't go
high twos.
Okay, yeah. So you can only go up to 10. How many times? 2 times 12 gets me up to 10.
2 times 5.
2 times 5. All right, so 2 times 5, and you're right. You got up to 10, right?
Yeah.
You can't get to 11. So when we subtract, you get 1 left over, right? This number was the big number up front. That was the big number. It was what you took times 2 that gets me closest to 11. The remainder
is 1.
Is the 1. That number goes on the top.
5.5.
5.5. Now, you could do this by, you know, subtraction rule. You could do this by drawing pizzas, where, you know, each pizza has 2 slices.
Oh, yeah.
How many full pizzas could you draw? I would say, I would probably stay away from drawing. It would be way too much stuff. I think this is by far the easiest. Now, if you want a multiplication chart, I'll give you one. So you kind of know, like, what you need to multiply to get closest.
Yeah.
I'll give you one of those. Okay, I'll prep them off. Okay. But, yeah, so I think that's pretty straightforward. You're going to have 10 of these. I'm going to leave these on the board for you today. So your first ones will be these. So you kind of know exactly what you have to do. You have to do this.
Oh, the easy ones.
Yeah, the easy ones. And then the second group will be that. But I'm going to make the homework due. Yep, I'm going to make this homework due on
Friday.
Yeah, Friday. Due Friday.
Would it be okay if you left these up or?
Yeah, I'm going to leave them.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
we're going to stay there.
So we get an idea
rest.
From it.
What? Yeah.
So we get an idea.
Yep, yep. All right. Here's
your homework. I need a new piece of paper.
Okay, here's your homework. It is page 64. I'm just going to go get 10. Exercise A. And you got page 66. 1 through 10, exercise A. So there's your 2 pages. There's your homework. And it is due Friday. You get some extra days to work on it.
So I don't keep messing up and having to scribble all out.
I'll go grab some. Eric, what was your question, sir?
Well, we have time tomorrow.
Yeah. Yep. I always show you a couple days. Yeah, let me go grab some pencils. I need some in here.
So,
2, 4.
Yeah.
Sixties 4 and 66.
Jeez, we jump.
Stop the camera in here.